It's December, and around this time of year, we of course have the Rankin and Bass Christmas specials. Some are a bit better than others. So I'm going to rank all 19 Rankin and Bass Christmas specials from worst to best. Now, I'm only doing the Christmas specials, I'm not including Mad Monster Party or Here Comes Peter Cottontail, because those are Halloween and Easter. I'm also only including specials that were made by Rankin and Bass. There are a few sequels to Frosty and Rudolph that came out years later, but they were outsourced to other animation studios, not made by Rankin and Bass. So if there's not a special on this list, it's either not a Christmas special, or it wasn't made by Rankin and Bass. So let's get started. Coming at last place at number 19 is The Leprechaun's Christmas Gold. This special has almost nothing to do with Christmas. It feels like it was written to be a St. Patrick's Day special, but they realized Christmas would be more profitable, so they very quickly changed it to be loosely tied to Christmas. But really, this is just a tale about leprechauns and leprechaun mythology that definitely would have worked better as a St. Patrick's Day special. Number 18, Rudolph and Frosty's Christmas in July. Now, as an idea, having the Rankin and Bass special share a universe and having them cross over like this is a cool idea. The execution here is awful. First off, like the title implies, it doesn't even take place at Christmas time. It takes place on 4th of July. And the plot is just so bizarre. There's an evil wizard who serves this shadow monster something. It kind of reminds me of Darth Vader and Palpatine. And he makes an evil twin of Rudolph. And I don't know, the special is just weird. Also, it's almost 2 hours long, and it feels very stretched out. This was actually released in theaters, but it didn't do very well, and yeah, you can see why. Number 17, The Life and Adventures of Santa Claus. This feels very redundant, because they already did a Santa Claus origin movie, and the way this one is feels very much like Lord of the Rings, which is kind of funny, because Rankin and Bass also did a Lord of the Rings Hobbit movie. But I will say, this special was kind of daring. I mean, right off the bat, it tells you, Santa's gonna die. We need to figure out a way to make him immortal. And, I mean, that's a pretty dark way to open your special. And it just gets weirder from there. But this one was just bizarre. Number 16, Cricket on the Hearth. A very forgettable Christmas special based on Charles Dickens' other Christmas story that's lesser known. Honestly, I barely remember anything about this one, other than the main character goes blind, the villain wants to marry her. I don't have any major gripes with this one. It was just very bland and forgettable. Number 15, 'Twas the Night Before Christmas. The biggest problem with this one is that Santa is a huge jerk, because a mouse who doubts his existence writes a letter to him saying he doesn't believe in him. Santa decides to punish the entire town, so they have to make this big grand gesture to apologize. And wait a second, isn't this just the plot of that one Phineas and Ferb Christmas episode? The animation also is not that stellar, and it's very forgettable. Number 14, The First Christmas, The Story of the First Christmas Snow. Angela Lansbury and Cyril Richards are the only memorable thing about this movie. The plot's pretty bland, and I forgot about it almost as soon as it was over. Number 13, The Little Drummer Boy Book 2. A very cheap, unnecessary cash grab sequel. I honestly almost can't remember a thing about this one. The story's very cheap, and the songs are forgettable. It was just an attempt to make a quick buck. Number 12, Pinocchio's Christmas. This is just an absolutely bizarre special that makes no sense. It's trying to tell both the story of Pinocchio while also trying to be different, and it's just a mash of too many ideas, and it just doesn't work. Number 11, Santa Baby. I didn't hate this one as much as I thought I was going to, but it's still pretty meh. It does have a lot of style, both with the animation and the music, but the plot just isn't that interesting. But at least it has Earth the Kit. Number 10, Rudolph's Shiny New Year. Again, a very cheap cash grab sequel, but this one does have some fun ideas. There's these islands that are all different years, so it kind of feels like a time travel movie, and that's kind of cool, but overall the plot just isn't that great. Number 9, Jack Frost. Now, if we're going with the idea that these are all in the same universe, as evidenced by the Rudolph and Frosty's Christmas in July movie, then why is Jack Frost a hero in this one, but the villain in Frosty's Winter Wonderland? Especially because this one was made after Frosty's Winter Wonderland. Besides that, the plot is just The Little Mermaid, but gender-swapped, with a few changes thrown in here and there, and I wouldn't have noticed this, except the narrator is the same voice actor as Scuttle from The Little Mermaid, so that's what I was hearing, and that's how I made that connection. And then I was like, wait, this is just The Little Mermaid. Like, it's almost the exact same plot. It's watchable, but it's not that great. Number 8, Nestor the Long-Eared Christmas Donkey. So what if we did Rudolph again, but somehow made it even more depressing? It's the same story as Rudolph, But this time, the main character's mom dies protecting him from the cold, and he's abused by a cruel master, and at the end of the special, he goes back to him. So, yeah, this is a very depressing special. I don't know what they were thinking. Number 7, Frosty's Winter Wonderland. This is cute enough, but it's so beat-for-beat the original. They even reuse the same dialogue and jokes, and having Jack Frost be the villain here, but hero in the Jack Frost movie, even though they're supposedly in the same universe, makes no sense. Number 6, The Stingiest Man in Town. As far as adaptations of A Christmas Carol go, this is one of the better ones I've seen. It tells the story in a quick and concise way. I enjoyed some of the songs, but it feels very safe. It feels very easy, like they put the bare minimum of effort into this one. Number 5, The Year Without a Santa Claus. I like the Snow Miser and the Heat Miser song, but that's it. Like, this is a very convoluted mess of a special. It should have been half the length it is, because it feels unnecessarily stretched out. Number 4, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. This is, of course, a classic with memorable characters and fun songs, but a huge problem I have with it is Santa's a jerk. Like, he shames Rudolph's dad for having this kid with his red nose, but, like, shouldn't Santa be the voice of reason in this movie? Why is he acting like such a jerk in this? Number 3, Santa Claus is Coming to Town. This is a pretty fun way of telling a Santa origin story, but it is a little bit dark. Some parts of this movie are really depressing, and some parts of this movie are pretty dated. Number 2, Frosty the Snowman. A fun, simple, cute little special that just takes you on a fun adventure with a likable, childlike, naive main character. It's fun, it's cute. But coming in at number 1 is The Little Drummer Boy. The songs are fantastic, the animation is fantastic, the story is great and well told, the main character is a great character arc. It tells a simple story in about 25 minutes. It really is one of the few Christmas specials that's still genuine and religious. It doesn't feel the need to, you know, be consumeristic or come across as overly cute or anything. It's still very genuine, still believes in what it's saying. Very genuine, very religious Christmas special. So it comes in at number 1. So go ahead and share a ranking of the Rankin and Bass Christmas specials that you've seen, and I will see you next time.